plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
Bruce! And hold tight, welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video. Today we're going to look at expansion vessels on heating systems. What I'm going to do for you today is we're going to cut apart an expansion vessel. We're going to actually have a look inside it and see what's inside one of these things. Then we're just going to have a quick look at where they are in a pressurised system, how they work, what they do, and love like that. Anyway, people, I hope you enjoyed today's video. And remember, hold tight! What you have in an expansion vessel is, got water on this side. This is heating system water on this side. And on this side here, you've got compressed air. Cold water, when heated up by the boiler, the molecules start to move more. This is basic science. And because they move more, the volume of the water expands. And so you need an expansion vessel to take up that expansion on a sealed system. Now, usually, if you had an open vented system, you have an expansion pipe that goes up in a crook into the top of your tank, the F&E tank. Because you don't have that here, there's no expansion pipe, you need to use this to take the expansion. You cannot compress water, it's really, really difficult, but you can compress air. So, say you've got 1 bar of water here, cold, and you've got 1.5 bar pressurised air on this side. The water here, when the boiler cuts in and comes on, will slowly heat up, and you'll be able to watch the pressure gauge on the heating system go up and up and up from 1 bar, gets to 1.5 bar, it starts to push into here, pushing this air and compressing that, and then it should just hover about and be very, very happy. The problem is that a lot of the time these do go wrong, and the main problem for that is the divide between the water and the air. You usually have a thick rubber diaphragm, and it is effectively a moving part, and moving parts are always prone to going wrong. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut this open and have a look in here, so you get a good idea of actually what's inside one of these. And then when I've done that, I'll be able to show you one on a system and also give you a quick drawing about actually where they fit in a system. Blah! People, because we're using a grinder today, we do have to wear personal protective equipment. Make sure you wear a box, a thigh pad and an inner thigh pad. Pads. Some protective gloves. A helmet. And of course, eye protection. Now we're ready to go. In all honesty though, being serious, it is really important when doing any kind of grinding or any work really, where your eyes might be in danger, to wear protection for your eyes, and in a minute when I put them back on, wear gloves to protect yourself. If you ever need to recharge the air, this is where you'll do it. This is called this is a Schrader valve. These are the same sort of valves that go on bike tyres. At the time, if you've got a problem with your expansion vessel, a symptom being that the pressure goes right up, or sometimes the high pressure relief valve dumps, pop your finger on here. If no air comes out, try and repressurise it and see if it'll work. If you leave your finger on here for a long time, water starts to come out, you then know that the rubber diaphragm has gone in it. Well, let's get grinding. So now we've taken this side off, we can actually see the two different sides. Now, here we've got our rubber diaphragm. What's happened is in the past, that has basically broken. So at the moment, this is the actual expansion vessel when it's actually in an unpressurised state. So the system pressure is probably at about 1 bar and it's cold. Now this area here you can see in front of us is air. It's full of compressed air. At the bottom, we've got a small inlet, and on this side, we've got water. Now, as the system heats up, the water expands and pushes up into the air that we can pressurise, we can compress air. So it pushes up, so when it's at a fully pressured state, our diaphragm will be up here. Now the problem is that these do fail. As I said, it's kind of a moving part, and when they do fail, as you can see, we've got loads of heating system waters on the air side, it shouldn't be there. Now that fluctuation and change happens constantly throughout a heating system's running cycle. As I said, you can repressurise the air at the top with the Schrader valve and do it like that if you've got any problems, and also the Schrader valves are really good way of figuring out if there's anything wrong. Now I'm going to give you a quick idea about how these schematically fit onto a heating system. So let's have a quick look at how these systems work. We'll have our boiler, our pump, radiators, and then back to the boiler. Now usually what you'd have is when the hot water heats up, it will go up on an expansion pipe in a crook and then into an F&E tank. That's a feed and expansion tank. And the expansion, when this water heats up, will go up this pipe, and it really should just hover at about this level. So instead of having that, what we have is we have a cold water main in that comes in, now it goes through a check valve, then it will go through an isolating valve, and then it will go onto a small manifold that will go down and feed the system. Okay, so water will go down through there. But because we don't have that expansion, our expansion vessel will be fed just up here and will sit there like that.
So there's our diaphragm. We've got loads of water on this side. We've got air here, water here. So when the system's cold and there's nothing in it, it's cold, the system will be like that, okay? This is all air here and that's water there. The system's nice and cold. There's nothing going on. When it gets hot, this will go up to here and that'll be water there. So that can take the expansion and therefore you don't have any problems. We have covered this in another video about pressurized heating systems. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. Let's go and have a quick look at what one of these look like when they're piped up. Now, the installation I'm about to show you was not me, all right? That's the one thing you need to know. The installation you're about to see was not me. I didn't do this because it's absolutely bumhole. Right, so here we go. Here's one on this heating system. Here we have our cold water main in. Here's a check valve here. Then we've got our pressure gauge here reading 1 bar at the moment because this system is off. We've got a high pressure relief valve here. Then we've got our actual expansion vessel on the bottom here. So we've got water on this side here. Then we've got our diaphragm in there. And then we've got our air on the bottom. Now you may notice that this is a slightly smaller expansion vessel. That's because you have to rate the size of the expansion vessel to the size of the heating system in litres. Now this heating system here is really, really small. So there's not a whole lot of water to expand into the air here, so you don't need such a larger expansion vessel. But if you had a heating system of say 20 radiators and loads of underfloor heating, you'd need a massive expansion vessel. So there we go, that's one in situ. Now you know what they look like when they're in an absolutely dreadful installation like this one.
Right, so there you go, you've now learned how to put cricket pads on and get ready for your session of batting in the world of cricket. You've also learned about expansion vessels, what's inside them, how they work, because sometimes that big ball of metal in front of you can be a bit of a mystery. If you need any more help or any more information, give us a shout through our website at plumberparts.co.uk. Of course, you can also subscribe and also follow us on Twitter and Facebook. Somewhere here, I hope. We tweet loads. We also retweet loads of pictures of the stuff you guys are up to. Please come back next week. We've got loads more videos coming up. We've got some power flushing videos to do. There's loads more coming up. And as ever, subscribe and give us love. I hope to see you in next week's video. And until then, let's hope it gets a bit warmer. And remember, everyone, to hold tight throughout the day. See you later.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.